Yo, what is going on YouTube? It's your boy Dan, aka A-Drive. Bring you guys a brand new video today, and today we are going to break down every single character in Unite and the optimal held items to use to give yourself the best chance in ranked play and beyond. We're also going to discuss whether or not a Pokemon is physical or special, which has created a lot of confusion in the community. So this is an action-packed video, so make sure you guys stick around for the entire thing and get yourselves ready because there's a lot to learn in this one. Be sure to like the video if you guys enjoy it, and of course subscribe to the channel if you guys are new, as I've been posting a ton of Pokemon Unite content on the channel and I would really appreciate your support there. So guys, make sure you're subscribed, you don't want to miss out. And last but not least, I've been streaming every single day, 8 hours a day on twitch.tv/adrive, so tune in there if you want to watch me play live. I've been having a lot of fun. I'm working my way up to master rank. I've been playing with a lot of friends like Austin John and other content creators. We're having a blast doing that, so be sure to tune in there. But without further ado, we're gonna jump into this video and we're gonna break all of this information down. And again, I'm gonna show you guys some really cool sets for every single Pokemon in the game. I'll do my best to put timestamps in the description below if you just kinda wanna jump ahead to your favorite character, but I recommend you stick around for at the very least the beginning part here, as I'm gonna break down the physical and special Pokemon in the game. So here we have the full physical and special split breakdown, and this has been something that's been confusing for a lot of players, but we have it right here. So a couple things I want to point out. Something like Zeraora is a physical attacker. So no, whether or not it's using Volt Switch or Spark or Discharge, those are all physical attacks. Greninja, also a physical attacker. Whether it's using Water Shuriken or Surf, those are all physical attacks. When we look at special attackers, Pikachu, any of its moves are special attacks. Alolan Ninetales, special attacks. Venusaur, special attacks, etc. The one thing I want to mention, though, that I think is very important to note, is for all Pokemon, their basic attacks, so like you just pressing A, not pressing the shoulder buttons, those basic attacks are actually physical. So there's some unique instances with some of these Pokemon, like Ninetales, potentially using a muscle band to increase the attack speed and buff those basic attacks. Some of them on the third hit turn to special. But again, I'm going to put the full document for Serebii.net in the description below. That way you guys can actually look at every single Pokemon. But the general rule of thumb is basic attacks are physical, and then the Pokemon's classification on this screen behind us is what their other attacks are. So Charizard, its flamethrower is physical. Zeraora, its Volt Switch is physical. Cinderace's Ember is physical. I think it's just very important to know, because a lot of people have been confused about this. People have been using the wrong held items and everything like that. So by having this page here, now you know exactly what you need to know. Feel free to screenshot it, save it. And again, I'll have the reference in the description below for Serebii.net so you guys can take a look at all the exact breakdowns. But it's very simple if you just think of it that way. Basic attacks are physical. The third hit for some Pokemon is special. And then for their shoulder button options, so like Ember and Pyro Ball and Volt Switch and Water Shuriken and Surf, it depends on the Pokemon and the classification they fall into to determine what held items boost what. Now, before I go into every single Pokemon, I do want to emphasize that I'm no expert with every Pokemon, right? I've played, you can see level 20, I've got how many games played? I have no idea. I've got quite a few games played if I were to look. I'm gonna actually look because I'm curious how many games I've had played. I've got 192 games played at this point, right? So I've played this game a significant amount at this point, but by no means am I an expert in every character. So I'm gonna break down every Pokemon, but I'm gonna show you guys something very cool that will help you moving forward. On the home screen, you can press the X button. You can go down to Battle Prep, and you can go to Held Items. This is actually really cool. You're gonna go to Give Items to your Pokemon, and you can click X to change Pokemon, and we're gonna start at Venusaur. When I'm on Venusaur, I can press the Y button here, and I can see recommended item sets for every single Pokemon. So we see here Venusaur, which we know is a special attacker being used by these Venusaur Masters. And what these Masters are the three highest ranking players of that character by win percentage over a certain threshold. I would like to see that change later for highest person in a certain rank, like Master Tier. But right now, most of these people have won maybe like 15 or 20 games with this character and haven't lost yet. So it's a really good baseline. I think over time, this page will become even more useful. But we see here with Venusaur, we see the Shell Bell. We see the Scope Lens, rather, to boost those critical hit ratios. We actually see the Muscle Band, which is going to boost Venusaur's basic attack, which is like his little vine whip type attack, and also increase its movement speed on that, or its attack speed rather. But again, your basic attack is physical, but all of Venusaur's other attacks are special, which is why we see the scoring shield here to protect it from scoring. And then we see the special attack specs, which actually gives it a buff on scoring, much like Shell Bell is boosting its special attack. Here we see that float stun for movement speed, and of course the Shell Bell, and then again the Muscle Band to try to increase that attack speed of its basic attack and buff that ever so slightly. Moving on to Charizard. Charizard, again, a physical attacker in this game. We see Energy Amplifier, Buddy Barrier, Muscle Band, Float Stone. We see an Assault Vest there, Float Stone, a Muscle Band. So again, some various items there and some really good suggestions on how you can utilize Charizard. I think Float Stone's really good. It's going to give you that buff. It's going to increase that movement speed. Muscle Band, incredible, obviously, being able to increase your attack speed here on these offensive characters. So that's a really good baseline. Alolan Ninetales here we see. Rocking that Muscle Band again to increase its normal basic attack because of how good Alolan Ninetales' basic attack is. But then we see the Wise Glasses, we see the Shell Bell, we see Leftovers, Wise Glasses, Shell Bell. Again, this is all a really, really good baseline for every single character to give you an understanding of exactly how you can approach this game. Switching to a more support-oriented character, we've got Wigglytuff here. But again, people are running Wigglytuff pretty offensive. We're running it with Wise Glasses, we've got the specs, we've got Focus Band, which is an item that I'm actually gonna be testing a lot today. We've got a bunch of different stuff going on here. Assault Vest as well. No Rocky Helmets on Wigglytuff for these top players. Shell Bell to increase its damage. Because again, Wigglytuff is a special attacker. And we look at this image again, and you think of Wigglytuff going for Double Slap. It is a special attacking Pokemon. So you want to use the items that are going to benefit it most from a special attack perspective. With Slowbro, we're seeing a lot of those special attacking items as well. Leftovers. Rocky Helmet on this one. Focus Band. Focus Band is very good on those high HP characters like Snorlax, as when they get dropped to low, it gives them a ton of extra health, and especially if you can level that up to level 20, you're getting a significant amount of health back, and you're kind of creating that sustain for this Pokemon. So again, you can look at these recommendations here and really get an idea of mixing and matching and trying to find the best combination based on what you've already powered up and based on what build you're trying to run with that Pokemon. Now, obviously, Gengar, an incredibly hyper-offensive character here, running Float Stone, which, again, you're going to just use that to increase your movement speed to move around the jungle. A lot of people using Float Stone for that movement speed buff. You see trying to increase critical hit rate, increasing Muscle Band to just increase your attack speed. Because, again, Gengar's really bread and butter here is to farm jungle as fast as humanly possible. So even though Muscle Band isn't going to boost its Sludge Bomb or its Hex or any of that, it's going to boost its basic attack, which is going to allow it to attack faster and ultimately farm those jungle Pokemon faster. But you see this character, or these people are using those glasses, of course, and of course the Shell Bell, which is giving it a little bit more power. I'm a little surprised to see Leftovers there, but that's probably just because you're moving through the jungle a lot and you're getting that residual health anyway. So again, Gengar, an incredible Pokemon right now, probably the best Pokemon in the game in my mind. Some really good suggestions here. Now, I can tell you, I ran Mime all day yesterday, and I was running some similar sets to this. I was running Wise Glasses, I was running special attack specs, and I was actually running Scoring Shield. I really think Scoring Shield is a very, very good item. Very difficult to deal with if you're on a high HP character. Focus Band seeing some love here as well. So some really cool stuff with Mr. Mime. Lots of special attacking options. Which, by the way, Mr. Mime has significant damage output in the late game. Here we got Snorlax. A lot of people running Float Stone to increase its movement speed. A very slow Pokemon otherwise. Rocky Helmet, Focus Band. This is the standard set. You can see all three of the top Snorlax players are running the exact same set here. So that's a really good baseline and a really good indicator that this is probably a good bet to start with at the very least. Now here's Absol taking advantage of Scope Lens, of course, increasing its critical hit rate, going along with its Super Luck passive. Float Stone moving around faster, Muscle Band increasing those basic attacks as well and their attack speed. This person's running Leftovers in exchange for Float Stone, which gives it that passive if it's in the jungle. Again, just trying to get that residual health. But ultimately, you're going to want to run that Sylph, or that Scope Lens rather, to increase those critical hits. Float Stone gives you that movement speed and also allows you to get that, get around that jungle a lot faster. I've played a lot of Crustle, and you can see here Shell Bell on this one. A little surprising to see Shell Bell again. Crustle, a physical attacker, but the Muscle Band, the Focus Band there, Assault Vest, Float Stone giving that buff. We actually see the critical hit buff there with Scope Lens. I'm wondering if Jim Boom is trying to utilize that with X-Scissor, because X-Scissor hits three times, so you essentially have three times the chance of getting that critical hit. I kind of like that as well. That's something to play with for sure there. And Zeraora, again, a physical attacker, despite the fact that it has special attacks like Volt Switch in the main series game. In this game, pure physical attacker. We're actually seeing this person's running Shell Bell, so again, probably not the best item, but I can see it, you know, I see the recovery, I guess, but probably not the best item. Floatstone, Muscle Band, we see Leftovers. Again, this is an instance where, because the game is new, some people are kind of making some mistakes here. There's really no reason to run Glasses on Zeraora. Zeraora is a physical attacker in this game. And again, people still trying to learn the ropes, still trying to make it happen. This guy's got the attack weight there. But I would definitely take this one with a grain of salt. So far, we were doing good until this one. Cramorant is a special attacker in this game. So you see the special attack specs, the Shell Bell there. We see the Buddy Barrier, which is really cool. We've got the Scoring Shield, which I really like. You've got the Wise Glasses and the Muscle Band to boost his basic attack. So a lot of boosting items here. Lucario, one of the best all-arounders in the game. We actually rated it as our highest rated Pokemon in our tier list. Of course, Floatstone, you've got the Muscle Band to increase your attack speed. You've got the Rocky Helmet on this person, trying to increase your critical hit ratio there. So I would say some combination of Muscle Band and Floatstone, and then the last item seems to be pretty interchangeable. Some people running Assault Vest, some people running Rocky Helmet, and then we see the Scope Lens there for the last person. Here's Pikachu, which we know is a special attacker in this game. And again, I think that it's important to know that all of these menus are subject to change as players kind of play the game more. We see these rankings fall. But we see, again, a lot of special attacking items here. Focus Band there, Floatstone for movement speed, Shell Bell, Muscle Band for its basic attack, of course. We see the Wise Glasses again for Pikachu. So again, focusing on its special attack stat. Machamp utilizing the Floatstone, the Muscle Band, trying to increase those critical hits. A little bit of bulk added here. Floatstone, Muscle Band, and the Assault Vest. You can see the trend here. This one's actually running Leftovers and the Scope Lens to increase its critical hit ratio. I think some combination of Floatstone and Muscle Band, probably a good bet. Especially if you're going to the jungle with Machamp. Garchomp, a physical menace here, rocking that physical Muscle Band, Assault Vest, Scope Lens. I don't know why they're running Glasses on this one. Floatstone, Muscle Band. I would tend to think something like a Floatstone, Muscle Band, and then maybe Leftovers, or you could even consider attack weight to boost your attack stat if you're looking for that. I'm not sure why they're running Wise Glasses here. Not good. Not good. This is what happens, though. The game, you know, now we have more data in the game. We are understanding the special physical and special split, which is why we're making this video, of course. Greninja, of course, a lot of people thinking this Pokemon is special. It is not. It's physical. We see Assault Vest, Muscle Band. We're seeing Floatstone, which is good. A lot of sound stuff here. So, again, just refer back to whether or not a Pokemon is physical or special anytime you guys are deciding what items you want to run, so you can take advantage of them. Again, basic attacks are going to be physical, so there are opportunities for you to utilize those. But nevertheless, here's Talonflame. I think this is a really cool one. Attack weight, of course, the more you score, the more opportunity you have. Talonflame, a big scorer there. Floatstone, trying to get those critical hits. Muscle Band, I would say that I probably gravitate towards maybe like attack weight. I really like Scoring Shield, like I said, especially, but Talonflame scores so fast, so you got a couple different options there, but Floatstone, Muscle Band, definitely essential on Pokemon like Talonflame, of course. And here we're looking at Cinderace, a physical attacker, and you can see a lot of people using Muscle Band, Floatstone, Scope Lens. We've got Scope Lens again to increase attack weight, so when you're scoring, you're getting that buff. But again, focusing on physical attack for Cinderace. And last but not least is Eldegoss, a special attacker. And you can see Eldegoss is trying to utilize XP Share, the first Pokemon we've actually seen using that, because it generally kind of lags behind the opponent, and it wants to kind of benefit from that by leveling up, by not taking things out. Score Shield's there, pretty nice. Muscle Band, Buddy Barrier, Assault Vest for some love. Eos Cookie when it scores, getting a little bit of health there. So some really cool options and some really cool sets for various Pokemon. But again, you guys can always come in here, press the X button, go to battle prep, and then ultimately you can go to your health items, and then you can actually search every single Pokemon as the rankings change and get really good advice for each of those Pokemon moving forward. So that's a full breakdown of all the health items and the physical and special split in this game. Hopefully that you found this video helpful. And like I said, I wasn't gonna make exact guides for every single Pokemon when I'm not the expert of every single Pokemon, right? We're gonna live and we're gonna learn, and we're gonna learn this game together. But I felt like it was really important to show you guys this resource and give you a basic understanding of what items are best for each Pokemon for right now. Things could always change as things get tweaked and buffed and metas change and all that good stuff. But ultimately, I think this is a really good guide and a really good breakdown for you guys. So I hope you guys enjoyed it. Like I said, like the video if you did and subscribe to the channel if you guys are new. My name is Dan. I also go by A-Drive, and I will catch you guys on the next one. Peace.